Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I am going to show you how to write four letters in Farsi. It's not very difficult. Let's get started. All right, the first one that I'm going to teach you today is the letter B, and then we will learn the equivalent for the letter P, after that T, and at the end, one of the many versions of S, because we have more than one version for that. All right, so the equivalent of the letter B in English in Farsi would be pronounced as B. For P, we have P. For T, this version of T, we have T. And for this particular version of S, we have C. I'm going to show you how to write and how to remember each of them. Okay. Now, all of these four letters will be written in the same way. The only difference will be the number and the place of dots. So right now, we are just focused on the basic form of these letters. As you can see, it's not very difficult. One small line down, then one big horizontal line, and then we go up. Okay, so down, on the line, and up. Try to practice this particular movement. As you can see here, I have put a red tape as a line reference. So basically this part of the letter would be written above the line. Okay, now let's put the dots. If you put one dot relatively in the middle of this letter below, it will give you the letter B. Okay, so one dot below, it would give you the letter B. Now, I'm going to show you how other letters would be written based on the number and the place of dots. So again, it's exactly the same shape. Now we want to create the letter P. So this time you're going to put three dots, this particular form, two dots above, one dot below. So three dots completely below the letter, and this will give you the letter P. Now with B and P, these are the only ways of writing these letters. With T and C, there are a couple of more variations that we will learn later. So, now the third one is the letter T. So again, the same shape. I'm just repeating it for you to remember the hand motion with this. And now, this time, we have two dots above the letter. So the dots have to be relatively in the middle. So two dots above would give you T. Very easy so far, right? Now, the last one we have is one of the variations for the sound S. This one is called C. Again, you start with this particular hand motion, and then you put three dots on top. So it kind of looks like a triangle on top. And this will give you the letter C. Now, this letter is not very common. This particular version of S is not very common in Farsi, but, well, we do have it in some words. Okay. So, not that difficult, right? Now, I'm going to actually show you in more details how each of these letters will be written. And also, I will show you the small version of each of these letters, because as you know, in Farsi, all the letters are joined. When you write a word, you join the letters. So depending on where this letter falls in a word, it can either have a full form or a big form or small form. So we're going to see in a moment how each of these variations would look like. With B, this is the full form, or the big form of B. With P, as we just learned, this is the full form. You remember, three dots below. With T, two dots above. And with C, three dots above. Okay. So these are the full forms. Now I'm going to write down the small forms, or when these letters will appear in the middle or at the beginning of a word. So here we have B. You see, it looks as if they have been cut in half. You have to preserve the dots. So the dots will stay, but the letter itself will be cut in half. Okay. So this is the big version. And this one is the small version. When I teach my students how to write these letters, I always say, all right, keep the dots, but cut it in half. Keep the dots, cut it in half. Keep the dots, cut it in half. That's the way to remember. So you see the dots are exactly where they are in both versions, big and small. Obviously, because if you change the number and place of dots, you're going to get a different letter, or you're going to get a letter that does not exist. So be very careful with that. Now, let's get into more details. Okay. Here we have the letter B in English, which translates to B in Farsi, which is written like this in the big form and like this in the small form. Then we have the letter P in Farsi, is pronounced P, is written like this, the big form, and like this in the small form. Right? So, the third one is the letter T. One of the versions of this letter in Farsi is called T, which is written like this with two dots above. And the last one that we learned today is one of the versions of the letter, equivalent of the letter S, which in Farsi is pronounced Se and is written like this. Okay, now, how do we remember how each of these letters would be written? Again, you have to pay very close attention to the number and the place of dots. So with the letter B, one dot below. B, below. That's how you will remember it. B, one dot below. With the letter P, three dots below. Excuse me. So with the letter T, two dots above. And with the letter C, three dots above. So two letters have dots below, two letters have dots above. Okay. Now, sometimes some of my students come up with some visual tricks to remember these letters. For example, one of my students, Stefano, came up with this trick. When I was teaching him the letter B, he said, oh, it's like a bull. It looks like a bull. Because if you imagine, the dot would be like the head of the bull, and the body of the letter itself would kind of look like horns. So B, B, bull, the dot, and the horn. So you can come up with many tricks like this. Obviously, everyone has their own way of remembering things. But I just wanted to share a couple of these tricks with you as well. Now, we also have other tricks. For example, with the letter T, you can simply imagine that the English form of T is kind of similar to the Farsi word T, because look at the hat or the head of T. You kind of have the same horizontal line formed by two dots above in the letter T in Farsi. So T has a hat above, horizontal line basically, and the letter T in Farsi has two dots above, which kind of would form a horizontal line if you imagine them joined. In fact, some people do write these two dots as one little small horizontal line. So that would be another trick to remember, T and T. Now, we have the letter P here. Now, with P, maybe you can think of pie. Imagine a pie shape. A pie with three portions, three slices, basically. So here we have three dots in P. Pie, three slices of pie, three dots. And then with the letter C, it's quite interesting because C in Farsi also means three, number three. This is quite interesting. So when you learn numbers, I feel you remember from the other video I had, I guess, yeah. So number three is C, and the letter C has three dots on top. What a coincidence. It would help you remember it better. So I think it would be easy for you to remember now how to write each of these letters. Let's review. B is B with one dot below. P is P with three dots below, like the pie. T, one of the versions is T with two dots above, like the letter T itself. And one of the versions of S is C with three dots above. So this video was a little long, but I really wanted to make sure you will memorize everything right now during the video, so you wouldn't need to do it again. I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed it very much showing you how to write these four letters. Hopefully I will make more videos teaching you how to write and pronounce letters in Farsi. Khudafez!